保时捷911一直是这家车厂的招牌车款，更被当作超跑的代名词。到现在，每年13%的销售额都是由这个经典车款贡献。
You think of the Corvette, you think of the Mustang, those are very American models. You think of the 911, that's a global model. That's a model that every country collectors or car enthusiasts aspire to.
但经典车款却遇上大危机，欧盟立法要求2035年禁止销售汽柴油车，偏偏911采用后置式的引擎，如果电动化，几乎就得改头换面。保时捷因此投入研发一种所谓的合成燃料，号称制造过程可以抵消排碳量，欧盟也认可这种燃料可以得到豁免。
We cannot reach the fleet emission targets regarding CO2 by improving technique on the combustion engines. It was not sufficient, so we thought about how can we reduce the CO2 footprint. The idea came up to work on synthetic fuels to replace fossil fuels in our cars.
所谓的合成燃料其实就是利用海水电解出氢，在捕捉空气当中的二氧化碳结合，再制造出甲醇，再用合成甲醇作为基底打造化学结构还有特性都跟汽油非常相似的合成燃料。强调整个过程都使用绿能，因此整体就能达到碳中和。目前保时捷已经投入超过1亿美元，跟西门子还有埃克森美孚共同合作，在包括智利还有澳洲等地区进行生产。
There is a pilot project in the Magallanes region of Chile, an area on the southern tip of the country. Wind is exceptionally abundant there. Two turbines in the area can produce the same amount of energy as 6 in Germany.
去年12月，这种燃油已经首次加入保时捷911当中试用，今年3月开始商业制造。试行阶段，一年大约可以生产13万公升，预计2026年到2028年可以达到10亿公升。但海水当中提炼氢的过程还没有大规模量产，捕捉二氧化碳也是一大挑战。
You need to have the technique for direct air capturing. This technology is in fact not as far developed as the other technical parts, so this is a kind of a challenge to make this technique available and do the scale up.
技术上想量产还得再研发，因此合成燃油一加仑要价10美元，如果量产渴望降到一加仑7.57美元。尽管燃料价格让人望之却步，但对拥有名牌超跑的车主来说还是愿意买单。尤其保时捷号称出产的车辆有70%都还在路上跑，未来就得靠合成燃油续命。
If possible, and if the regulatory conditions are good and the customers want, for Porsche it would be an absolute option to keep the 911 as a combustion engine car for a longer time.
但根据国际洁净运输理事会的分析，虽然合成燃料制作的过程都利用再生能源，而且还用碳捕捉，但实际上能源效益不如预期。
According to the group, only 52% of the electricity, the energy that goes into the fuel production process, is actually captured in the final fuel. The rest is wasted. On top of that, 70% of the energy in the fuel itself is wasted when it burns in the engine. That means that only 16% of the total available energy is used.
环保团体更担心合成燃料成为汽车产业拒绝发展电动车的借口，但保时捷强调2030年之前旗下将会有80%的车款都是电动车，并没有减少电动车的研发，而且全球还有13亿要使用汽柴油的车辆，过渡期势必还是要仰赖合成燃料才能达到减碳目标，因此看好合成燃料的商业潜力。TVBS新闻综合报道。